Tell me about my great-grandfather, Mom.
You mean Tom Gothy?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, your grandmother, his daughter, told me that when he was 16 years old, he joined the cavalry in the Civil War. So after the Civil War was over, he boarded a train in Atlanta, and he went as far as Ocala, where it was the end of the tracks. He got out of the train, struck out for Bayport, which was about 80 miles on the west coast of Florida. So some men were in the woods there from Bayport, and they found him laying there almost dead from the lack of water. Well, they put him in a buckboard and took him into Bayport and nursed him back to life. And he decided to stay there. And he fell in love with a girl, Elizabeth, from Georgia. And they built their homestead and had a family. To feed the baby, they used to have to milk the wild cows because that's all there was. He worked for the Likes Brothers. They used to have a pencil factory. And he worked for Likes Brothers, and then he fished. Their children all left, spent their old age, and passed away. But Bayport up there, I went up there about 3 years ago. Except for a big, long pier out there, Bayport's just about the same. Wait till the Yankees find those good old fishing spots. Bertie, the only thing permanent is change.
Tin roof shanties dot the coastline of our home. It's been this way for years, and no one lives in fear. Some people find our pace a little slow, a fact we don't resent. You see, we're all content, and the stories at our tables are not lies. Perhaps exaggerated, but swallowed with pride. And it's a shame one day the modern way may overrun these shores. The progress of the concrete will surely change this island world. People, when they pass, won't have the mind to say hello. But not as long as tin roof shanties dot the coastline of our home. The early bird's already pulled his line. When it comes to fishing, he's the pride of the island. The big ones bite, the sun begins to shine. Mama's frying up the breakfast, it's redfish and it's fine. And the old dock master's leaning on his cane, waiting on the tide, praying it won't change. And it's a shame one day the modern way may overrun these shores. The progress of the concrete will surely change this island world. And people, when they pass, won't have the mind to say hello. But not as long as tin roof shanties dot the coastline of our home. Master's leaning on his cane, waiting on the tide, and praying it won't change. And it's a shame one day the modern way may overrun these shores. The progress of the concrete will surely change this island world. People, when they pass, won't have the mind to say hello. But not as long as tin roof shanties dot the coastline of our home.